calculating single discount equivalents. Series or change discounts are often expressed as a single discount rate, and that's what we're going to determine in these first series of slides. When we're given a series discount, we want to convert it into an equivalent one number representation for the discount. For example, if you were given a series discount of 15% and an additional 5%, the equivalent single discount would be, or could be expressed as 19.25%. How did that number get determined? Let's take a look. In this first example, they're asking us to change the series discount of 25 and 15% into an equivalent single discount. The first step is to multiply the complements. And recall that the complements are 100% minus the discount. This gives us what they're actually paying. So the complement of 25 would be 75%. And this series discount with two discounts will take the complement of 15%. 100 minus 15 gives us 85%. So the product of the complements is 63.75%. This is what they're actually paying of the list price. But then our second step is to find the complement of this, because the 63.75% is what they're actually paying. And if you subtract that from 100%, this single discount represents the equivalent of this series discount. So for a business offering a 25-15 series discount, they could have just as well listed it as a 36.25% off. In this next example, we are asked to change the series discounts of 30-20 into an equivalent single discount. Same steps. We want to take the series discount, multiply the complements of each of those. 100 minus 30% is 70%. 100 minus 20 is 80%, to come up with the product of the complements of this series discount. And in terms of the problem, it would mean the business is paying 56% of the list price. What savings are they garnering with this series discount? We need to find the complement of this product of complements. So 100% minus 56% means 44% is equivalent as a single discount to the series discount given of 30 with an additional 20%. Let's look at one more example. Express Video is offering a series discount of 20-20-20. States Video is offering a 40-10-5 series discount, and we're being asked which discount is higher. We'll use those same steps that we have in the previous two problems. We need to find the complement of each of these series discounts. The complement of 20% is 80%, and we're dropping that zero, which past the 8 on the decimal side is not changing the value. You could have 0.80, and it'll be the same for each of the other two discounts in this series. So it's 0.8. 0.8, 0.8, in other words, 80% times 80% times 80%, which is the product of the complements is 51.2%. That means that's what they would be paying of the base price. What are they saving? The savings is found by taking 100% minus that percentage. So the equivalent for Express Video is 48.8% expressed as a single discount. Repeating the same for the other business, complement of 40% is 60%, complement of 10%, 100 minus 10 is 90%, complement of 5%, 100 minus 5 is 95. Multiplying those three complements gives us this percentage. This is what the net cost percentage is, the savings then as a single equivalent is found by taking 100% minus the net cost being paid, which leaves us with a discount of 48.7%. Not quite the same as the Express Video, so Express Video wins out by a 0.1%. In this next section, we're going to determine or find the list price given the series discount and the net cost. We're going to determine the list price based on the formula for calculating net cost. We will find it provided we're given the trade discount and the net cost. And here we have an example that they're asking us to find the list price of a faucet set that has a net cost of $41 after a trade discount of 20% and an additional 10%. So here's our formula for finding net cost. We're looking for the list price. This is our base, so we are considering it 100%. How was the net cost determined? Well, to find the net cost, we took the complement of our trade discount, multiplied those together. 20% complement of that is 80% times the complement of 10%, the additional trade discount in this series is 90%. Multiplying those together gave us 72%. The net cost was 72% of the list price, and we want to find this first. We know what that value calculated out to because of what was given in this problem. We now have a rate and a part, and we're looking for the base, and it's the base because of its association with 100%. To find base, we will take part and divide it by rate. So we'll take our $41 net cost, divide it by the percentage that it is based on the list price to give us the original or the list price of $56.94. In this next problem, they're asking us to determine the list price given a net cost and a trade discount of a series of 5, 10, and 20% off. Using our net cost formula as our basis to set this problem up, treating the list price as our base associated with 100%, we will calculate our rate for the net cost by taking the complement of each one of our series discounts. 100 minus 5 is 95%, complement of 10% is 90, complement of 20% is 80. Multiplying those complements together gives us the rate that the net cost represents of the base. We know the net cost, which is acting like the part in this problem. So we have a rate, a part, and we're looking for the base. To calculate base, we will take part divided by rate. And simplifying gives us our answer, the list price of $2,280. In this example, we're given a net cost of $1,125, a trade discount of $25, and an additional $20, and we're being asked to find the list price. Again, that foundation formula for net cost, treating the list price as our base, which is equivalent to 100%, the whole amount. We first need to calculate the complement of this series discount. The first discount is 25%, its complement being 75, complement of 20 is 80, the product gives us 60%. This is the rate that the net cost represents compared to our base list price. We're given the net cost, this is the part, and to find our base, we take part divided by rate to give us our final answer, the list price of $1,875. In this last objective, we're going to compute a single discount rate when list price and net cost are given. So in this variation of the net cost formula. We're given the list price, we're given the net cost, and they're asking us what the single trade discount being offered in this situation. In other words, what's the savings? How much money was reduced? We know our total, we know our net cost. We can find the amount of discount by subtracting the net cost from the list price. So the discount amounted to a savings or reduction of $74 from the list price. What does that translate into in terms of a percentage? We will take our discount amount and treat it as the part and compare it to the list price, which is the base. Doing the division, we come up with a decimal, and converting it into a percentage gives us the discount rate.